left side wing, it's Oling. Oling finds Chapman down in the left block. Chapman, nowhere to go. Kicks back out top of the key to Rougeau. Rougeau for three. Can't knock it down. Rebound for Foster. Foster, count the bucket. And one. 36-35. Maple Leafs down by one. And Kyla Foster, when it counts the most, coming through with a clutch and one potential here.
Yeah, and she becomes the first player on either side to reach the double digits mark. She's got 10 now. And looking to convert her second old-fashioned three-point play of the contest. She had one in the first quarter. Really off to a hot start here in the third. Exactly what the Maple Leafs need, and she could tie it up here.
And she does just that, 36 apiece, with 8:34 remaining here in the third quarter. And it's going to be Parrott to bring the ball up for the Cougars, but some full-court press action coming from the Maple Leafs. Easily broken by the Cougars on the right side wing. It's Pate. Pate pulling for three. Can't knock it down. Ball knocked around, picked up by Oling. She hands the ball to Foster to rush up the floor. Foster takes it coast to coast. Too hard off the glass. Board for Chapman, and Chapman drops it in. 38-36. Maple Leafs right back in front with 8:07 to go here in the third.
Great control by Kyla Foster on that last drive. Wasn't able to put it down, but she was able to control herself and not, like, throw a wild shot.
Crow on the left wing for the Cougars. Crow back up top to Parrott. And Parrott slows it down for the Cougars. Parrott, top of the key, driving in now at the left. Nowhere to go. Picks up her dribble. 6 seconds left on the clock. Finds some room and is able to finish. 38 apiece to score. 7:37 remaining here in the third. Cockerham driving in with the left. And Cockerham finishes after nearly being ripped on the drive. 40-38. Maple Leafs back in front. And this one is turning into a back-and-forth ball game. On the left side wing is Crow. Crow has nowhere to go. Great defense by Chapman. Kicks it out right side wing to Pate. Pate back over left side wing. Crow for three. Can't knock it down. Cockerham comes down with a board. Cockerham brings it up the floor for the Maple Leafs. Cockerham hands the ball off to Foster, and Foster will reset at the logo.
Really the first time the Maple Leafs have slowed things down over the past four drives.
Right side wing, Cockerham finds Boots. Right corner for three. Can't cash it in. Cockerham, big offensive board. Loses the ball out of bounds afterwards, and the ball's right back to the Cougars. 40-38 the score. 6:50 remaining here in the third. Maple Leafs lead.
A couple substitutions. Andrea Rougeau coming out there for the Maple Leafs. Sends Cockerham to the bench, and Dunnick is going to make her way out there for the Cougars.
Bringing the ball up the floor for the Cougars is Parrott.
Fast and furious quarters so far. Both teams trading points.
Parrott guarded by Foster. Crosses half court. Sets up shop at the top of the key. Parrott. Shifting to the left side. Tries to drive in with the left and finishes off the window. 40 apiece.
We've seen that off the window drive multiple times here. Not only near in this half, but also near the end of the second from the Cougars. That's been a shot that's worked well, really well so far for them.
And it just seems like the Maple Leafs aren't able to contain that nasty little crossover that any of the guards for the Cougars have had to this point. Foster brings the ball to the floor for the Maple Leafs. Once again, tie ball game, 40 apiece with 6:25 remaining here in the third. Top of the key, it's Oling. Oling finds Chapman, right block. Chapman driving in down low and finishes off the window. 42-40, Maple Leafs back in front. 6:12 remaining in the third.
Maple Leafs saying, whatever you can do, I can do better. They go back down the other way and basically put up the same shot.
From the right block, it's Crawford. Crawford, nowhere to go. Great defense from Chapman. Kicks it back to the top of the key to Pate. Pate passes right side wing to Crawford. Crawford driving inside. Fouled on the shot. She'll head to the line to shoot two.
Yeah, good move there by Crawford. She went through about three defenders there to make that, to put up a shot and get drawn on the foul. Foul is going to be on Kyla Foster. That's her second.
Kyla Foster's done a great job again tonight of being light on the fouls but very aggressive on the defense.
And at the line now is McCassidy Crawford. And her first shot is up and good. Make it 42-41. But so far, St. Francis not doing extremely well at the free throw line. They're 9 of 15 now, just over 60%.
Second shot on the way is no good. Keeps the score at 42-41. Maple Leafs still in the lead with 5:49 remaining here in the third quarter. Foster driving in with the left, and easy finish for Kyla Foster. 44-41, Maple Leafs extend the lead.
Foster with an excellent play there. Looked like she was going to slow things down and kind of direct traffic from that offensive standpoint. really just decided to fake everyone out and move inside
instead.
And
a big rip for Emmy Boots, but Chapman is ripped again. And it's going to be right back to the Cougars. Top of the key, it's Dunnick, and a foul going against Dunnick as she got trapped up at the half-court line and got a little bit too aggressive trying to create some space.
An interesting situation there as well. Cassidy Crawford and Dunnick were both fighting for the ball. Crawford actually had to go up into the stands and kind of work her way around to get back out there on the court.
Kyla Foster will bring the ball up the floor for the Maple Leafs. Foster over to Oling on the right side wing. Oling finds Chapman on the right block, and Chapman just no love from the rim on that shot. Ball's in and out, and a full court press coming for the Maple Leafs.
I think they're going to get Rougeau there for a foul.
And they are going to get Rougeau for a foul.
That's her third. We got a substitution. Rougeau's going to head to the sidelines. Coming out for her is Grayson Cockerham. We'll see how she does.
5:03 remaining here in the third quarter. 44-41 the score. Maple Leafs lead by three. And it's going to be Fueling to work it up the floor for the Cougars. Fueling. Shaded to her left side. Now goes back to the right side. Passes over her right side wing to McKnight. McKnight looking down low in the paint. Ball out of bounds. Last touch by Emmy Boots. So the ball stays with the Cougars on their side of the floor.
Poor pass there by St. Francis. He was really into double coverage, and it wasn't one of their taller players that they were going after for the pass. Cougars kind of lucky that the Maple Leafs were the last one to touch that as it goes out of bounds.
Fueling takes it out for the Cougars. She looks in, finds Crawford right block. Crawford can't finish, gets her board for a second attempt. Nowhere to go, kicks out left side wing to Pate for three, and Pate buries it to tie the ball game up at 44 apiece. 4:35 left here in the third.
Way too many opportunities there for St. Francis. Maple Leafs have got to do a little bit better right underneath the net trying to get those boards.
Foster on the right side wing. Nowhere to go, finds Chapman top of the key. Now hands the ball back off to Foster. Foster to the left side wing to Boots. Boots reverses the floor, now driving in with the right. Fouled on the shot. She'll head to the line to shoot two, and that shot nowhere near going in. The Maple Leafs will take it, a free opportunity at the stripe.
Chloe McKnight picks up her first foul of the contest. All tied up here, Boots at the line. She's 5 for 5 on the season so far at the line. 100%, make it 6 for 6. Leafs are able to take the lead with that shot as well, make it 45-44, 4:15 to go. In the third, another crucial shot here for Boots at the line. It's up. It's good.
46-44, Maple Leafs back in front with 4:15 left here in the third. And Fueling brings it up the floor for the Cougars.
Maple Leafs have already matched their second quarter output about 5 minutes in.
Top of the key for the Cougars. It's Pate. Pate the left wing to Fueling. Fueling driving in with the right, and Fueling can't finish. Just too hard off the window. Rebound for Oling. She'll bring it the other way for the Maple Leafs. Foster right side wing. Hands the ball off Chapman. Chapman trying to drive inside. Fights through some contact. And her shot's going to be blocked down low. It'll be Fueling taking it the other way for the Cougars. McKnight right wing for the Cougars for three. In and out of the rim. Just didn't want to go through. Rebound. Cockerham headed the other way. 46-44. Maple Leafs still lead. And a foul on the floor. With 3.5 minutes left here in the third.
Yeah, well, it's going to go on Cockerham. The foul against Aubrey Dunnick. That's her second. Couple substitutions. Cyan Muhammad makes her way out onto the court for Tanish Chapman. And coming in for St. Francis will be Sydney Crow and Tiana White.
Kyla Foster will take the ball out for the Maple Leafs. Foster surveying her floor, looking over the options. Finds Cockerham on the left wing. Cockerham driving inside. Short teardrop. But she knocks it down, 48-44. Maple Leafs extend the lead to two possessions with 3:20 left here in the third.
That's the kind of shot selection you love to see from your senior out there. That's a perfect shot for her. Mid-range, nailed it.
McKnight on the left wing for the Cougars. Pulls for three, short off the iron. And a foul will be staying here. That one's going to go against Cockerham, who knotted it up with Tiana White.